Hey guys, welcome to our channel, All Three Turning. Welcome back. Today, as requested, we're going to be reacting to Fire in the Booth, Ecola Part 4.
Part 5? Not 4. Let's get to it.
What?
Let's see what it is.
Part 4.
My next show!
Very strong language and adult themes.
I know you gonna dig this.
Oh yeah, perfect.
You ready, cuz?
Always, bro. Always.
You know what time it is when you hear this, right?
Let's get ready to rumble!
Yo, listen. 10-year anniversary. Carla.
I see your dreadlocks. You got some dreadlocks now.
And I could have sworn in the first few Fire in the Booths he had an afro. He had an afro. And then you said, in the third one, you said something about like him having like freeforms or something.
Yeah, with like freeforms.
But had him like.
Yeah, started in dread.
What was the like span of part 3 and 4 that made him like barely have dreads to having like really long dreads? Like, these took me 2 years to get. So, it must have been like a few years between part 3 and part 4 or something. Comment down below.
Let's get back to it.
Turn up!
Uncle Akala, the flow farther. You already know that I'm smarter than half of the darker. The shit get harder. I spit yet fools when I act like they can't get a quick death. How many careers have been ended in a time that I've only ascended? Just telling things how they are now. Why would the truth be offensive? I was independent when everybody signed. Still independent, respect my grind. Own my own masters, know what that mean? Understand back catalog, are you green? Scene means that my kids have a pension. I ain't got kids, just thought I would mention. See my intention, mangle a mention. Murder a syllable and strangle a sentence. Stand to attention. All of your henchmen still couldn't bench him because he's too heavyweight regin. Like old school jungle selection, come through humble a veteran. 10 years since the first album, 10 years no daytime radio, 10 years still touring, that's real.
So you've been in it for 10 years?
10 years since his first album.
10 years since he's been.
Well, his first album.
And 10 years since he's been. touring. That's what you say, right?
So he like went like dropped his album and then immediately toured.
He been probably doing it for a minute.
Build his fan base up so when he dropped the album, everyone was already prepared for it.
That's how you do it. That's tight. Yeah. You can see the different stages in the videos we watch.
That's what I was asking, like, the time stamps of the Fire in the Booth part 1, 2, 3, and 4. Because he started 10 years ago. Like, I don't know how long.
So probably part 1 was 10 years ago.
I don't know how long this radio has been around because, you know, I'm not actually out from there. So
Fire in the Booth. How long Fire in the Booth been going on? Let us know.
Or like, let us know when part. Well, we could have said it ourselves, but like when part 1 came out.
Then let us know.
If y'all let us know before we look it up.
Let's get back to it though.
Porters, we all know why they don't play me though. I'm not rapper. Rap about matters that actually matter. Challenging power, war. Every single tour is 10% more now. Why do you think that happens? Content matters, albums matter, songs they matter, lyrics they matter, integrity matters, flows it matter. It's worth the skip, but we deal with the matter. No industry hype. Just write what I like. It's this DB call with a mic. This I am Mike. What in like? Cause a fight is a roll of the dice, like rolling on ice. Organs openly sliced. Cold, I told you the price. Colder than ice. Nah, colder than life. Living in a war zone, hold my advice. Take shortcuts, get.
He said, organs openly sliced cold. That made me think of organ harvesting.
Stephen and Carolyn, this case started here, according to sources, when a man named Arthur Rathburn was shipping human body parts through Metro Airport. Get this, the box leaked blood. Those cargo haulers then called for help.
Why were you stockpiling hundreds of human body parts here, sir? That's Art Rathburn. And remember his business 13 months ago? For 2 days, federal investigators dressed in hazmat suits removed body parts of 1,000 different people, arms, legs, heads, cut up and kept on ice, not embalmed, so they would be fresh for the black market.
Let's get back to it.
short. Long road, hard road, but more short. World tour that I'm doing at the end of the year should make all this clear. Some only get visibility. Some silly fool called me a failure. I smile to myself. These times I was on a plane to Australia. Sold out shows on the other side of the globe, but fools only know what's in front of their nose. So they stunt, pose, but they can't sell shows because their music is poo and they got no flow. I know you might be astonished. Dog shit cannot be polished. No matter how you push it on the public, son, you cannot make them love it.
Dog shit cannot be polished. My great grandma told me that shit.
Your great grandma? Your great grandma?
Yeah, her last words to me.
Oh my goodness, okay. Enough joking for you.
Let's get back to it though.
That's what you've been saying though.
It is a saying. That's why he's saying it. That's what my grandma said it. Great grandma.
Okay.
Let's get back to it, y'all.
Son, you know how many rappers could pack out a venue in Addis Ababa. Guess what? It was the only one Bob Marley ever did play in Africa. You write raps, I write history on the page. And quite literally an elder statesman to my own generation. An inspiration, cause the flows that I came with is a solo play by Miles Davis. Who don't know he's the greatest? So if Charlie tells anybody else that Fire in the Roof is the best there's been. Is he high? Does he lie? Nah, he knows that I'm in my own league. I'm judged totally separate if we actually...
He said Miles Davis is the greatest. Not second degree.
Who's that? Mel Davis?
Mel Davis, if you like a kind of like a blues type guy.
Like, what's that time frame when like jazz?
Like the Dizzy Gillespie. Jazz players in the 50s, 40s, 30s.
Yeah. But there's like a time when they're like booming, like where they had like jazz clubs or something like that.
The roaring 20s.
Yeah. 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 And then they had a, what's her name? She sings like, my skin is black.
My skin is black. My arms are long. My back is strong.
But I thought Nina Simone, however you found her name, was like back then, earlier than the 60s.
Oh, nah. They expressed their feelings, you feel me? Let's get back to it.
Going on the evidence, you wanna be a folder, you know what the level is. You wanna be a pro, can you roll with the cleverest? Genius, I know it. Kinda like a roadside tug, get a poet. Kinda like a warrior, kinda like a scholar. But I could be an arsehole, don't make me show it. I know a certain kind of supporters don't like when I get this mosey. You think that I care? All that show, you don't really know me. See, I'm an arrogant fuck on the mic. I am not humble, I'm only nice in real life. Who wants an MC that does not think that a shit? That defeats the whole point. Combat sport, this rap stuff. That's why a man gets slapped when he act up. They cannot catch us, they will get backed up. You can feel the energy coming through the chakras.
Man gets slapped when he act up.
How does it feel to be told to shut up?
We've talked about...
Let me speak! How does that feel? How does that feel?
Do not.
No, but he said something about Kamaba's chakras. He's spiritually aligned.
Gotta be. Let's get back to it, y'all.
No aggression, the hood's not listening. Cause aggression is what they're living in. So I keep spitting it, every day I'm spinning them. Call me a caller, there is no sin in them. Nobody's similar, not the same. I rap about life, they rap about chains. Yet, we all get dough and we all drive mercs. All do festivals, all get work. We don't all lecture but ox.
He said that he rapped about life and other people rap about chains. But they still have, like, have concerts. They're all still like. So I feel like it's kind of deep.
Okay.
Okay.
No, because like even if you rap about life and you rap about like the most stupidest thing, like you're still gonna have like a fan base. Some people like live, some people like chains, some people like bulls, some people like switch around here and there. So that's cool.
Oh yeah. People like what they like.
Yeah.
Let's get back to it.
With a hoodie on, cause I got no response for that nonsense. Don't all do education in war zones. Man, I shook to go peck 'em. Despite all the big talk, they were not walking half of the places I step in. Catch me in anyone's hood on my own. Kids act like they seen a ghost. I'm like, little bro, I'm 32 years old. You think I care about a postcode? I'm not invincible. I could get removed from the physical, but if I get murked, probably be political. Cause the things that come out of my mouth is a madness. I am a rebellious bastard with no respect for authority. So I don't suggest that you follow me. It's true, this could all end horribly, but I still be the anomaly and entrepreneur. I don't say because it sounds cool.
He said, if I get murked, it was probably political. No, that mean right. What?
You say too much and people want to, like, silence you by killing you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Apparently, two men approached the speaker's rostrum and discharged shots at him from apparently very close range.
As I turned around quickly, and the next thing I saw was Malcolm falling back in a dead faint.
Rappers, dot, like, what they call those
holistic
doctors.
Is it just me? What the world could change? Years going by, now it's getting strange. Murder rate goes up, and hip hop's the blame. What about the world killing more than
it just shows they have a lot to hide out there. And if you ask me, they want to keep you in the dark.
It's actually true. Ain't got a diamond chain, I admit it, but I do got an office with employees in it. Do take youngsters all around the globe, get them paid for the brain and the lyrics while media wanna still paint us like we are just nothing but crooks. Along comes one so cool, it can make it cool to rap about books. And you can think that's sneaky and stupid, but all that show that you're clueless. Cause the global revenue from books every year is like 10 times more than music. Now I've sold how many books and self-published, how does that look? For those that only respect checks, swear the accountant ain't cooking the books, son. And I don't even think that capitalism should decide how you write a rap on a rhythm. That is the age we're living in, isn't it? It's all about materialism, more important than any paper debt. Do you check for the youth them? Let's see. Any one of them little tugs right there, it could have been me. It could have been me. It could have been me. 15, I was in Chimes and Trends, Coliseum Way.
Do you agree that we live in a time that's more materialistic?
It doesn't seem to make sense to suggest that there might be such a thing as good materialism. After all, isn't materialism just plain bad, always? It can seem as if we're faced with a stark choice. Either you can be materialistic, and that means obsessed with money and possessions, shallow and selfish, or you can reject materialism, be good, and focus on more important matters of the spirit.
Let's get back to it.
Back then, surrounded by big men and the clap of a skeng. You know what's being smoked in green, but everybody pretends. These time I kick ball for the hammers. Weed in the girls, put a spanner in the matters. Fact of the matter is, lost my discipline. Late night brethren's whip with a stick in it. He took it from under his dad's mattress. I never grew up with dad, who's better off? Complicated, I'm undercompensating. Everybody talks road, I let him fake it. My oldest was organized crime, they lick manks. So I ain't gas when you say you bag grams. Bad man, what's that? Madman, stop that. They manufacture gas, we just pop that. They import, export, we just shot that. Hustle ain't saying I'm not that. I'm just saying we should see it's deliberate. And by now we should all be sick of it. I'm working on ways to get rid of it. Mass incarceration ridiculous. So I go jail and I chat to the man them. Firing the booth part one, what I rap them. Explaining the system and how it will trap them.
The instrumental for this part is like so uplifting. Like I just imagine that like in the background and you just like run to the top of the hill and like I like get my like little whole thing and say, like, you know what I mean?
Let that be.
That's actually a really good, yeah, instrumental. So let's get back to it.
More than rap then, all my fire in the booths. They have been studied as texts by countless PhDs round the globe. My youth now have some respect, and they still bang on the block from Brixton to Brooklyn, Palestine to West Papua. But despite all the personal comfort, I still feel sick when I think of the massacres. The world is fucked, there's enough to go round, but we are all back. There goes preaching again. Akala, stick to the script, just stun. Tell him about your whip, brand new Sutterman sit. How many girls wanna? Well, cuz, come on, let's be honest. I was not ugly before this shit. So you can imagine, but the brain power you cannot fathom. I mean it truly from the bottom of my heart, though. Please jump on the bandwagon, I've made it. Cool to be conscious again, say thanks, cause I know that you got more sense. I know that you know yourself when you were sat down with your grand and the friends. That's our culture, respect for the elders. If it's not coke, let me call you a coke kid. No biggie, wanna ramp with a Carla?
He said, man, it's cool to be conscious. Let's get back to it.
so silly. I'm like my grand's name, So Millie. 10 years, first album, 10 years, no daytime play. But in October, we're selling out Coco. Come along, learn about a show on the stage. No hype, man, no cup in the mic. Musicians and visuals all mixed right. I like 40 songs squeezed into an hour and a half. Your supporters actually know. Consistency matters, the rest is just package. Imagine these rappers is tragic. Sitting at home, having to watch me. They're like, I swear it's black magic. Yeah, black magic. Griot, tradition of the rappers. I study my craft, you man, them are slackers. Bow in the presence of greatness. So you're only trained to rate fakeness. Love that I get is so overwhelming. I don't even see no haters. Yeah, few men have got more status. Which one has more respect? That's what I thought.
Thousands of believers gather in Wida, the historical center of the religion, to receive blessings from the voodoo chief. The ceremony is one of Benin's most spectacular and colorful events.
It's dinner time, has like really bad magic.
But it might be good.
Yeah, something with it. The only time, because like, remember when you told me how like they have like everything black is considered bad, like a black horse is bad luck, black cats bad luck, black magic is bad.
Really?
It could be the other way around. Like, black magic could be good, black cats aren't. Everyone knows black cats.
I always have a black cat though.
Aren't bad luck.
I grew up with black cats.
So did I.
I love black cats.
So who knows? Like, black magic. I don't know what he was kind of referring to it as, though. He just really didn't talk to me about it. But he's knowledgeable about stuff, so, you know, he'll probably do some research about it if he's, like, talking about that something.
Yeah, you know what you're talking about. Yeah.
Carl is the one that they still can't get. Cause I'm like Dennis Brown meets DMX. I'm like Shabra and Brocky and Depp. Running down old school Stratford Rex. I feel sorry for whoever comes next. That's like running after Usain Bolt. That's like singing after John Holt. That's like trying to floss on the Pope. He's so beyond money, he tries to act broke. I'm like every book written at once. So I got the youth's head fucked like skunk. Little bit of reggae mixed with a bit of punk. And the discipline of a Buddhist monk. Like how it feels when you come, she comes. At the same time, now you are one. Oof, you will swear there's a God when you're done. Even if you know you don't believe in one. Son, all of my children have left the building. Charlie can't have them back cause I've killed them. If I don't feel them, they ain't real them. Fate is still then. Just don't deliberate over the ill estate soldier. The middleweight roller didn't we take over. Didn't we take over the middleweight roller. The ill estate soldier deliberate over. Lines.
Hmm. This is an interesting part of the vibe with Aquila version.
Let's get back to it.
I rhyme with a force, so hard it separate your mind from your thoughts. Know that I am inclined to divorce your little big mouth from the height of your horse. See, it's a sign of the times that we walk. Those that talk sense get a line in chalk. Those that talk shit get a line of support. Right round the block for the minds that they bought. For the dominant philosophy, the legal arm robbery, the global monopoly. This fucking up the only planet that we got. If I had my way, I'd tell the truth, I'd let them rock. But unfortunately, it's not. Fuck off. This is so easy, I love this shit, but I'm almost bored. I could write one of these every month, but to give them a chance, I've only wrote 4 core. Man, I'm not training. They're not ready for the levels of Shaolin. That's almost the hour of bars, my dog. None of which is on my albums. And I got 6. And I write books and plays and scripts. Still find time to go teaching the bits.
He said he got 6 albums. And he write books. And he do everything else he do.
That's a lot of albums. And then, like, writing books. Because books take time and dedication. Albums take time and dedication. So, you know,
he's pretty busy in his craft.
Yeah.
Let's get back to it.
You that he's not the shit. Well, a bloody liar he is. I want this. This little idiot try chat to me and you know me can't feel it. Why try smile me your eye them tally? Too damn big for your belly. Not on your Nelly, not on your life. Could you find one to touch him on the mic? Yeah, right. Imagine a famous rapper from the States barring for 10 minutes straight. With the bloody cheek to do it double time every time. How much piss does he take? Knows that he's great. Knows that you're fake. Knows that he won't have a bar from your mate. Knows that you're late. Look at the anticipate every word that I say when I speak. Cause it's the knowledge of Timbuktu mixed with the slang of a London you. Add it in a heart and a soul of the blue. My youth now, how can I not go true? Half of a cracker plus half of a coon. Half of a kelp plus half of a room. If I'm feeling anything that's close to home.
He said knowledge of Timbuktu. And sung by the European Jew.
It's a language of a European Jew or
something? That's probably what he makes with or something.
Yeah. Where is Timbuktu?
Timbuktu is in America.
America?
Yeah.
there. It makes me look like it's in Africa or something. Exactly. Are you sure? Is it like South America?
We can look into it. Mm-hmm. Get back to it though.
You're half more than half tune, half of my tune contains more content than every single thing you'd ever do. Guessing is easy, but only a few could spit content and still slew. I'm sure you noticed this true. One of them is not you. You what? You wanna have a Barney with the magic mount, the machine gun armies, with the only one that is channeling Marley. You watch rappers while I'm studying Garvey. Left that. We can all see who's the best that you came for Connect for. I came for a chess match. Not the same league, even the same sport. Literally hundreds of stamps in the passport. Not the same league, even the same sport. Literally hundreds of stamps in the passport. And I ain't this black women to make my living, so who's more successful than him? Yeah, I got love in my heart, but it's not all peace and love. Nah, are you kidding?
He said, I didn't diss black women to make my living.
This, that, and this, and it's like that, and like this, and like that, and it's like this. Then who gives a fuck about those?
So just chill to the next episode.
Cause you know they degrade black people.
Have we decided on anything?
Yes, I have a white wine.
Okay. And for you, miss? What's wrong with you? Can I get a beer? Can I have a beer? Dog, he act like he seen a baboon or something.
Black women, black men, they degrade everything black nowadays.
But especially in rap culture.
Exactly. Let's get back to it though.
Yes, there are things worth killing and dying for. Ends ain't one of them though, what are you lying for? Now if a man runs in your house, thumps your mom in the side of her mouth, who in the right mind wouldn't understand why you ended up taking him out? Yes, love is not soft or sorry. Love is so tough it can make your mum catch your body. Love's the only thing worth killing and dying for. That's what I've learned in my time on this earth. Think that I'm wrong? Go to a lifer's wing. Look the man them in the eyes.
Maybe an unpopular opinion, but I don't think love is worth killing and dying for.
You think it is?
Well,
if somebody killed your daddy, you want to try to kill them? Or get them killed?
That sounds so horrible. I mean, yeah. Well, that sounds horrible.
I'll fuck somebody up for what I love. You know what I'm saying?
You would die for what you love?
Yeah. If somebody came through knowing right now, I would have to die for what I love. And I ain't gonna die, though.
I have a more like when you're like dating somebody and it's like, oh, I love them.
Oh,
like,
you ain't gonna kill over who you dating. Because that
do.
Comes and go.
Some people do.
Oh, no. We don't do that.
Some people, that's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Like, unpopular opinion. Like, but like, if you have family members. Yeah, exactly.
But somebody you dating.
Or, like, I don't know. It's not worth it.
You fuck around and die and then they be dating your best friend after you dead and shit. Yeah. It's not even worth it.
It's not.
Like, that's not worth it so much. My earbud came out.
it was like blasphemy. That's when I was growing up. I was like, you have family members and you love your family members and you would like die for them. But then it's like, you have like friends from like high school.
They'd be the ones to kill your ass.
Yeah, or like a significant other that you've been dating for less than like 3 months. Like, you're like, oh, that's my heart. I would die for them. Like, no, stop.
They jump off a bridge together. Let's get back to it.
Done that many times, but one too many rhymes. The London in my lines, a dungeon for these guys. Crush them to define 100 at a time. Muster, I define the cusp of what is rhyme. Clutching and I climb up the level line was always at the top, but now they recognize. Trust that you recline when I go double time. The flow is so ridiculous, I do prophesize. Guys are ill advised to dive into a fight with I, the wicked eye. You will never get a blight.
You were going hard on that part. You were him hard.
So far in the music video, how do you think his flow is and like all that stuff?
It's different. You know what I'm saying? Like you said earlier. He's not speaking on political or...
Well, he is, but just not as much as his other songs. Like, his other song, it was just like, fact after fact after fact. And this one is more of just like spitting his personal bars. Opinions on
stuff. He's spitting them bars.
Yeah, but just more different than his other ones.
That's all right. I appreciate it. Yeah. Let's get back to it, though.
And it seems I was there. Where? Everywhere. Every battle ever fought. Every stab. Every shot. Through the ages of humans, this killing machine. I could feel everything though. It wasn't a dream. I was every soldier that I'd ever fought. With a shield and a sword. All the blood ever drawn. From a dagger. Or a bayonet, an axe that will slay your neck. All my gas to clap, only spray.
He said a sword, a dagger, and an axe that'll slay your neck.
That one girl. You know that axe killer girl? You heard her?
The one from the
1800s who like yacked her parents.
No, the 1800s.
Oh, the 1800s. Or like, yeah, it was like the 1800s. Or early, no, it was the 1800s.
A murder that created a sensation in the genteel Victorian era city of Fall River, Massachusetts. And the prime suspect in the case became an infamous American legend. Her name was Lizzie Borden. Stepmother Abby instructed the housekeeper, Bridget Sullivan, to wash the first floor windows of the home. In the meantime, just after 9 a.m., Abby went upstairs to remake the beds and change the linens in the guest bedroom. It was the last time anyone would ever see her alive.
You haven't? They made a whole movie on Lifetime about her a long time ago.
In death. I was in a tank that exploded in a rock. In a drive-by gang war spraying out cars. I was in Nam. Dropping napalm. But it burned my skin.
He said he was in Nam. Dropping that in napalm. You know what napalm is?
Napalm?
Yeah.
Napoleon Dynamite?
How was school?
Worst day of my life? What do you think? Idiot!
Bruh! No. You wanna drop in Napoleon Dynamite? Napalm is a bomb. Oh, correct. They got like some sticky stuff. So when they blow up, little sticky stuff will get all on you, and you can't get it off, and it just fucking burns to your bone or something. That's napalm.
What was the whole point of Vietnam War anyways?
Oh, man. It's political.
But like we want land or something?
No, we didn't want no land, but it was something. I was born in 74.
But I was born in 2002.
But it was something going on.
Let's get back to it.
You heard what she said, y'all.
I was in Soviet Minh. I was in Italian massacring Ethiopians. But the bullets only pierced my flesh because I was both of them. I could feel every single wound of the flesh. But also the pleasure of causing the death. I was a soldier of the caliphate on a crusade, a killer. Using Christ in exactly the same way. I was every woman ever killed in a witch hunt. Or every little girl forced to grow with a split soul. Cause men like to snip clits or zip bits closed. So their rape feels nice.
So in the witch hunt stuff, said that back then, I read like this tweet that was like, that was the time where like...
Tweet.
I know it's not credible, but someone was just talking about it. Like at the witch hunt times, that was the time where like guys could kill girls over anything. Yeah. And it's like, oh, she's a witch, so we can like kill her.
They still do it in Africa, I think.
The witch hunts in Kisii are often based on accusations without proof. The poor and elderly especially are being targeted by organized groups. In this incident 3 months ago, villagers watched as a group of youths torture 5 suspected witches. No amount of beating is enough for the bloodthirsty mob. And soon they set their victims on fire.
Let's get back to it.
before they take my life. I was fighting for liberation, a woman and a general, bringing death to cowards that sold my genitals. One moment, I killed to be freed. The next, I was a monarch that killed for my greed. Thutmose III, Alexander the Fake, Caesar, Napoleon, Francis Drake. Arms of the state, with armies that are great, but I was also the resistance that's hardly ever praised. I was every indigenous person of America that died trying to protect their homes from a predator. Then a robe clad in Roman senator, and every noble that showed you the ways of the treacherous. I was in the Belgian Congo hacking off limbs. In Rwanda, a cancer doing the same thing.
He said I was in the Congo chopping off limbs. Let's get back to it.
I was a Japanese general occupying the Philippines. A Filipino child too young to know what it means. I was at Sharpeville, I was just two. My mother, with a bullet in her head, and I knew. Barely out of her womb, I played with her wound. I knew life was a cycle, she would be back soon. I was a soldier of Ashanti resisting the British. But at the same time, still selling humans to the Dutch. If you're honest with yourself and you look back through human history, you'd see that we're totally fucked. Cause I was that little girl in that church in Alabama. Then the grand wizard, then Margaret Sanger. Then I was Paul Warfield, Tibbetts Jr. Feeling just fine in a B-29. I did my job. 100,000 dead.
You said 100,000 dead.
The point of views of people in really sad times. Moments, sad moments.
Really? And he said, what did he say? Mama got shot in the head?
Yeah, that was actual mom, or just like somebody who was in like a war and like had experienced that from their parent.
Probably, I would hope it. Mom to get down like that.
That would be sad. I don't know, like, everyone comes from like really sad backgrounds and happenings.
Oh yeah. One day I give y'all story time. Y'all can hear my background. Crazy. Well, let's get back to it though.
I went home to relax. Then I was every child ever born with deformed limbs. Cause they were just pawns on the board to inform kings. I saw sharks following ships, intrigued by the trail that comes overboard. I saw sharks following the ship I was on. I knew then that it couldn't be long. We had tried to get free, but as if that were wrong, we were thrown overboard from the deck of the zone. So many bodies that the sharks couldn't finish the flesh. It took the waves to administer death. And I joined the rest at the bottom of the sea.
He said so many bodies the shark couldn't finish. They got tossed in the sea. That's deep. That's crazy. Let's get back to it.
The uncounted millions that dream to be free. The next minute I was back on a ship, this time as a soldier of the French. Right off the coast of Haiti, we made a gas chamber for African rebels. I couldn't deal with the stench. Then my head was chopped off by one of Dessalines' henchmen. He gave the order for killing all Frenchmen. Then all I could see was pyramids. Can you see? Designed by man's mind.
In Haiti, was it? Where like the white people try to come and like colonize them, but like they fought back and they won.
The growing fear of slave uprisings in the American South was intensified by the success of the rebels in the small Caribbean colony of Haiti, known then as Saint-Domingue. Saint-Domingue had been the most brutal of Europe's colonies in the New World and the most successful, until a violent slave revolt in 1791 had changed all that, releasing hundreds of thousands from their bondage and overturning the plantation economy.
Yeah, they won though when they tried to come over there.
They fought back. And it was just crazy because I remember.
We did.
Remember here? I think you showed me the video that talked about it.
Probably.
Like all that stuff that happened, like they tried to come and take the land, and people, and they're like, nope, we're not having it.
Like, oh, fuck your head.
Most people did die except for the woman.
Built by his greed, the strangest pyramids I ever did see was not built by stones, but the bones of families.
That was depressing.
I can dig it.
Yeah.
Wow.
That went like a really sad turn. He went from, like, the beginning to having the
juiced up
panda
and then
instrumental,
down.
And now it's just like, world's, world's tiniest violin. No, it's like this. Okay, it's that small.
Like this.
Yeah. Well, like, it wasn't my, out of all of them, because I think this is the last one of the color by the booth. Yeah?
Yeah, part four.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's the last.
They asked for this.
Isn't this the last part? Yeah. Okay. But out of all of them, it wasn't like my favorite, but I did like it.
But yeah, he was spinning the bars.
He went from like talking about things that like more of like his like opinion kind of, and then talking about like political stuff, and then like woke things. To like switch it up throughout the song, I thought that was pretty interesting. You notice that?
Yep.
Even the beat, like he went from having like really like
up tempo a little bit.
Yeah, to like really like sad to like in the middle, like back and forth. So this was like all over the place in a good way. So how did you feel about the song?
Like I said, he did his thing. He spit a little bars, like you said. Beginning, he went more up on it, up tempo a little bit. Then he just starts slowing down. Then he starts telling you, talking to you about how you feel about, you know what I'm saying, what he was talking about. And that's tight. He had like three different vibes to the song, and it's tight to me. So like I said, thumbs up. Not fucks with it. You know what I'm saying? We give it a thumbs up.
Be sure to give us a thumbs up, as per usual. Be sure to subscribe and comment any more requests you have, because we tend to try to get to all of them.
We try. It's a lot, y'all.
Even if it takes months, we'll still get to it. We'll get to it. But yeah, like, comment, subscribe, turn our post notifications on, and we'll see y'all next video.
Go.